In this video, we're looking at a block that's dragged along a level surface experiencing kinetic friction. And this is a very general problem. So this block has a mass of M. It's being pulled on with a force that has a magnitude of T. So this is like the tension in a rope. And that rope pulls up at an angle of theta above the horizontal. And our goal in the problem is to come up with a general expression for the acceleration of this block as a function of theta. After that's done, we're going to use calculus to find the angle that maximizes the acceleration. So we start things out in part A by making a complete force diagram for the block. And we'll go ahead and start with force of gravity. So there's the force of gravity, or the weight of this block, and that's given by mg. Next, we can put the normal force into the diagram. And note that I made the normal force a shorter vector than the weight. And the reason why is that there's a component of the tension pulling upward, and that's going to help the normal force to balance the force of gravity. In other words, the normal force has to be less than mg because it has a little bit of help in the upward direction. So let's take a look at the components of the tension next. Our upward component of the tension is T sine theta. And there's our rightward component of the tension given by T cosine of theta. Finally, we need to get the force of kinetic friction into the problem. And we're told in the problem that we can assume this block is going to break loose and slide. That means it's sliding to the right. And that means the kinetic friction force is going to point to the left. And I went ahead and put in our little formula for kinetic friction while I was going. That's given by mu k, the coefficient of kinetic friction, times the normal force. So the plan for finding the acceleration here is that we need to analyze the forces in the x direction and apply Newton's second law in that direction. The problem is we need to figure out the normal force first so we can get the friction force and then apply Newton's second law in the x direction. So we're actually going to start with the analysis of vertical forces so we can get that normal force nailed down. So I have N plus T sine theta, those are my upward forces, must be balanced by the downward forces, which is just mg. And this is what I mean by a component of tension helping out the normal force to balance mg. And that makes N smaller than mg. So I can write down N is equal to mg minus T sine theta. So that means our kinetic friction force is going to be mu k times the normal force. So mu k times mg minus T sine theta. Now that we have that figured out, we can apply Newton's second law in the x direction. So we want to look at F net equals ma in the x direction. We're going to call rightward positive here. So F net is T cosine theta minus the force of friction, which is mu k mg minus T sine theta. And this is going to be equal to the mass of the block times its acceleration in the x direction. We could call that ax, but it's not too confusing to just leave it as an a. So solving for a here, we're going to divide both sides by m. And at the same time, I'm going to clean things up a little. So I'm going to distribute this mu k to both of these terms. And that makes the second term positive. And I end up with A is going to be T cosine theta plus a mu k T sine theta minus mu k mg. And this is all divided by m. Now in part C, the problem gets really interesting because we're going to find the special angle that maximizes the acceleration of this block. So somewhere between 0 and pi over 2, there's an angle that's going to give us the maximum acceleration here, and there's a lot going on there. As the angle gets steeper and steeper, the normal force gets less and less, which lessens the friction force, which would tend to make you have a bigger acceleration. But that's counterbalanced by the fact that the steeper the angle is, the smaller your horizontal component, which is what's causing the acceleration in the first place. So it's definitely not obvious by inspection what this angle of maximum acceleration is going to be, so it's a meaningful question to ask. The way we're going to attack this, because what we have here in part B is an expression for acceleration as a function of theta, is we're going to take the theta derivative of this acceleration expression and set it equal to zero. In other words, we want a prime of theta. Now there's a 1 over m out in front of that, but it's not going to matter because we're setting to zero after we do this derivative. And then I have the theta derivative of t cosine theta, that's negative t sine theta. And then I have a plus mu k T cosine theta, and then this mu k mg term, that differentiates to zero. That's not a function of theta. All right, so there's the theta derivative of the acceleration. And again, we're going to set that equal to zero to look for the special angle where this is maximized. So setting equal to zero, I'm able to multiply both sides by m divide both sides by t, and I end up with this simple expression, negative sine theta plus mu k cosine theta is equal to 0. So now I'm going to add sine theta to both sides and divide by the cosine of theta, and that gives me mu k equals tangent theta. So we're getting really close to our answer now. All I have to do is invert the tangent function, and I find out the angle that maximizes the acceleration is given by the inverse tangent of the kinetic friction coefficient. So that's a beautiful answer on that one. If you enjoyed this video, or at least found it useful, check out another one by clicking one of the links on the left, or click the Zach's Lab logo on the right to explore dozens of physics and math playlists. As always, you can leave your questions, comments, and requests in the comments section below, and I'll get back to you within 24 hours. Thanks for watching Zach's Lab, and best of luck on your math and physics journey.